Welcome back to the gaming chairs, and actually, it's just me. I'm all alone, no Patrick today. And actually, as you may be able to see, that we're playing YuGiOh. Well, I guess if you don't know how to play YuGiOh, then you wouldn't know that's YuGiOh. But we're playing YuGiOh today. Or you can talk about the video title. But what we're doing is I want to duel three duels with this deck. It's my Raccoon deck, and you can see right now. I'm going to just kind of quickly mouse over some of the cards that you guys might not be familiar with if you want to build this deck. And if you want to change it, go for it. And this should be all of the ones. So if you want to see what each card is, just go back and pause it at whatever time. And I'm going to be playing three decks, and if I can get a positive win to loss ratio, that means this deck is good. But if it's positive, that means this deck is iffy. And if they're like all really close, no, wait, if it's all positive. So if I get three, that means it's real good. If it's two wins, one loss, that means it's kind of good. If it has one win, two losses, that means that it's like, depending on how the two losses went. And if it's all three losses, then I was probably against meta, because I've been using this deck for a little while, and it's been pretty good to me. So we're going to go on the USA servers, and we're going to challenge Mecha Monarch to a duel. Alright. Oh wait, I just realized you guys can see that. Oops. Alright, we can do this. And this deck prefers to go second, actually. And you guys will actually see how this deck works. I opened up pretty good. I opened up actually really good. Because of the way that this deck works. So, they're playing Speedroids. Cool. Yes. During your opponent's turn, you can banish one. So, Speedroid, Tri-Eyed Dice. During your opponent's turn, you can banish this card from your graveyard and give the attack of this turn of a monster your opponent controls as a quick effect. Alright, so that's pretty cool. You just get out three. Whoa, that card art is amazing. Totem Bird? When either player's turn, the spell trap card is activated, you can detach two XYZ material monsters to negate the activation. If you do destroy it, it's card with strength attack. That card is amazing. Alright, so basically what you want to do is you want to activate Obedience School, so if you have no monsters on your field, oh, don't negate it, please don't read it, you don't, please, no, gosh darn it, I mean, I guess it doesn't matter too much, but that still kind of sucks. Alright, but it doesn't matter, so we can summon a Raccoon Pon Poco, so if it's normal summoned, you can special summon any beast, level 2, beast card from my deck on the field and face on defense position. You normally want to choose Baby Raccoon Tantan, because then when it's flipped, you can special summon any level 2 beast warrior or beast monster from your deck. And so you can start, like, chaining cards into other cards. And if you do that, then you can get out basically the boss monster. Not even a boss monster, it's this card. Oh, I had it, then I moused over Tantan. Right here. So, number 64 Royan Raccoon Sendeo. So basically you just get two monsters, you overlay them, and then when you detach one, you can copy the attack of any... No, we can let Pompoko die. Because then we can... Oh, I really hope that we draw Raccoon Belios. I'm jumping all over, I need to like finish one continuous thought. We got another Pompoko. Alright, but anyways, we can do this. So when you flip him, we can special summon any level 2 beast warrior from our deck. And you always want to go for your Kalantosa. Put in defense mode, doesn't really matter. Because whenever this card is special summoned by the effect of a beast monster, you can destroy any card on the field, which is amazing. I want to get rid of one of these two cards in his back row, so I'm going to try and get rid of some of his back row. And Solemn Notice, cool. Actually, that's even better. Because what you can also do is you can summon out this card, Valor Fawn. You can activate special effects, so you can ditch one card from your hand. I want to use my Magu Mole. And you can get back any card in your graveyard in face-up attack or face-down defense position. So if you run out of Tantans, you can like revive them with this card. It's pretty cool. And so I can get rid of all your back row. Twin Twister! No, no, my Fiendish. Doesn't matter. Unless it's face-down, no, it doesn't matter. And then, what I can do is I can special summon my... Actually, I try to summon on Goyo. Yeah, I should probably summon a Goyo. And I can start destroying your cards. Like it's nobody's business. Normally you can get out 4 monsters. Just like the way that the deck works, you can normally get out an even amount. But if it's like that where they negate one, you can't get out another one, you should normally go for a Synchro Summon. Because the deck only works with the 2 Royan Raccoons, the number 64. Also, Patrick may call me in a minute on Skype, so maybe he'll just join us mid-recording, and that would be pretty cool. So, okay. So we want to summon out our Pon Poco. Yeah, that back row is making me nervous, because why do we leave that in attack mode? Alright, so we'll summon Pon Poco. I want to test something, because I've never tested this. If you summon out Pon Poco and you special summon out a Kalantosa, does that count as a special summon? I'm not sure. I've never done this before. We're doing it live. Let's see if it works. Oh, it didn't work. So we make it blow up your back row. Yeah, he has something face down. Oh, that kind of sucks. Alright, I mean, we're going to go for it regardless, because I live no fear. Yeah, Patrick may or may not be calling me soon on Skype. Totem Bird. I just can't get over that art. That art looks amazing. Oh, he's negating my attacks. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. That's cool. I can do... No, I don't need his attack again. Cool. Also, that's another thing why I like playing online as opposed to real life. Because in real life, online, I can just check if I can do anything. But in real life, I actually have to know if I can do anything. Like, at the end of that turn, I knew I couldn't do anything, but I just checked until I was like, maybe I just forgot to normal this turn. I don't know. Also, I really like the music in the background. So you're gonna destroy my Pon Poco, which is cool. And then, I can't combo. Because this deck is all combo deck. Also, I don't know if he summoned out a few cards, but I'm not quite sure what he's trying to do. So we're gonna normal Pon Poco. Actually, we can put that card down to 0 if we wanted to. I don't think that we want to do that. Actually, alright, you ready? We're gonna go off this turn. Hopefully you don't have Torrential. Don't have Torrential. Torrential's... No, don't go for Torrential. Alright, so I'm gonna flip some Talentoso. Now, with Sea Koalas, it's effective if I control another Beast Warrior, which is my talent, my Kalantosa, and I can choose any monster on the field. Oh, you max seed. What is it? Yeah, you draw a turn. Okay. And so, I can make that card's attack 0 right now, and I'm going to do that. And then, I can do this where I can get out my Royan Raccoon in defense mode. Then it's okay, because I can activate his effect, where I can ditch the Talentosa, send out this card, my token, and it copies the monster that has the highest attack point on the field, which would be my YuGiOh. So, we can attack right through their card, and they used up all their tri-eyed dice, so they can't block my attack. I feel like that this might be a stall deck, an anti-meta stall deck, and then I can also attack my YuGiOh, giving me their tri-eyed dice, meaning it won't go to the graveyard, so they can't block my other attacks. Which is pretty. Yes, I want that card. And I don't care if they draw cards. And then if I wanted to, I could special summon out my... Ooh, wait, that's a tuner. I can get out Leo right now. I think I'm gonna do that. I mean, it kind of defeats the purpose, but you know what? I don't care. I got my beat stick on the field. It would be horrible if they're playing an Exodia deck and because of my one summon they got Exodia. That would have been mad. I would have been mad. Oh, this card is also like amazing artwork. If this card is Noble Seven, your special summon, you can look at the top few cards of your opponent's deck. If you want to replace them, you can only tribute one spiral target to one spiral monster, gain 500 attack. Yo, they can look at my top 3 cards. Oh yeah, it's the same top 3 cards. I was gonna say, that's kinda crazy, because they can arrange like my top like 9 cards. Nope, top 3 each time. Spiral card from the graveyard target. Okay, whatever. But I can get on another level 30. I get another 31 beat stick next turn because of my raccoon's attack or effect. Alright. Civilian. Detach one resource unit. Excavate the top card of your deck. If it is a spell trap card, add it to your hand. Otherwise, it's a graveyard. You can target one plant life monster in your graveyard. Is this a spiral deck? Yeah, I guess this is a spiral deck. I've never played against a spiral deck before, so I don't know how this works. You know what? That's okay. I mean, it's nothing compared to my raccoons, so obviously that means it's pretty bad, but I don't know. Maybe they'll make me want to eat my words. Maybe they'll Dark Hole Regeki. Because with this card, it's also another effect is, if there's another beast monster on the field, which there is, he can be destroyed by battle or by card effects. And that has screwed over a lot of people when I'm dueling, because they'll be like, oh, our Regeki. And if you have two of these out, they block each other, and you just can't get past them. It's amazing. And people will like, and some people don't read their cards, so they'll, I mean, I don't read some of my cards either. And so they'll always be like, oh, Regeki, and I'm like, well, no, they protect each other. It's kind of funny sometimes, and then we'll surrender DC right after. It's like, why? So, this person may be like looking to come back, because they're going to start synchro summoning. I think that they're going off right now. And he gains attack? Or, oh no, they... Okay, oh, they just went for Ghost Trick. Ah, Ghost Tricks. Once per turn, begin play this turn, you can detach one card from this, like one face of monster, have it attack until the end of the battlefield. And this card is in the graveyard. Okay. So wait, half of 31? That's like 1550. So you can... Alright, I see how this is. Alright, you can stop now, please. No, he just negated all my hard work. I hope this could... Because I know there's some Synchro Dragon that doesn't allow you to special summon. Is your turn? No. It was... I think it was Stardust Spark Dragon, where they had Vanity's Emptiness and Spark Dragon, where I would be like, oh, Night Beam, destroy one of your cards. And they'll be like, alright. That's supposed to destroy Vanity's Emptiness. But because of Spark Dragon, they just kept it. Whoa, this person does not know how their deck works. Okay. So wait, we're gonna use Wind Up? Yes, because Wind Up will let me bounce back a card. Mm-hmm. Maxi, it doesn't matter. I'm special summoning once this turn. Alright, so I'm gonna commit my Wind Up, and I wanna get rid of this card. Yes. That's the scariest card. I don't know what that does. Yeah, you wanna half my Leo Keeper's attack. Oh, maybe I should've... Oh, gosh darn it. Maybe I just screwed my pooch. Wait, what are you doing? You're having the card that's in defense position? I don't know what they're... Okay. Doesn't matter, I can activate his attack. I can get another beat stick on my field. Not quite sure what you're doing. That now I can destroy your cards. I'm not quite sure what that effect is. I'm not reading it. Oh, you're going to negate that attack? Okay, whatever. I can destroy that card. Hopefully. I'm not reading some of these effects. Oh. You do, cannot be shared by battle, okay. Whatever. And then, since this card is basically useless, I can just get that card in defense mode on top of him. And it just, oh, I should have put an attack mode on. I'm a dummy. But, whatever. Yeah. Actually, maybe that could have just protected my life points more, but I'm not quite keen. I just knocked it on my mic. I'm not sure if you guys could hear that. Also, I don't think that I can pause the recording if Patrick calls me, so I think... Okay, so I can put that up there. You guys might be able to see, like, the brim of it, but, I'm not even sure if it comes up on recording. Oh, crap, I didn't look at the card that was. Oh, okay, I can look now. Oh, it's another spiral card. Yo, that card looks pretty cool. Kinda looks like Yusei from like a distance. What? Fiendish was my next card? So if it's Chakra? Oh, cause he arranged the top three cards in my deck. I hope that, like, in tournaments they let you have like a pen and paper. So if you play Spirals, then you can be like, oh, let me look at the top three cards and arrange them in any order I want, right? And then you can be like, alright, I'm gonna jot these down so I don't forget. So if like, that was me, I'd forget instantly. And then you're gonna have to do this, keep our red eye die. Once card is normal, summon a special target, you can target one, speed guard, monster you control, except speed guard, red eye die. Require its level from 1 to 6, it comes up. Great. So that's not that bad. And you just made his attack 3900? Whoa, calm down. What the fuck was that? Gains 500 attack for each card my opponent controls? Oh. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? Okay, I see. Ah, oh, you get another ghost trick, stop it! Okay, half that card's attack, I guess. Whatever. I don't understand this person. I feel like that they goofed a lot, and they just don't want to accept it. Don't destroy my downer position, please. Please go for the wind-up kitten. I feel like that they will, just because they're like, oh, I can get more damage if I attack the wind-up kitten. Okay, they're smart. So, hopefully I can get something. Hopefully I can get my fawn. Okay. That can help me a little bit. I can get out my Ponpoco. Can activate his effect. Do I have another? If I can. What can I Tan-Tan into? Is that the question? Alright, I'm cool with that, man. So I can't really do much or anything else. But that. I think I have to finish that 3900. I want to do it on a ghost trick, so that's kind of daunting to me. Oh, so this episode's 12 minutes long. Oh wait, was that the how I was looking at the time? Oh, okay, cool. Yes, let me activate my fiendish on you. Do not attack me, please. Alright, please special summon. Is it or left? No, it's more. I have to set this card. Because hopefully you attack into it with your ghost trick, and then this, and then I can save my life points for another turn. But hopefully I can draw another obedience school so I can start going off. Ah, crap. Is this the card? No, it isn't. Okay. That's cool. Why did you do that? Why could you be dumb? I hate it when people I'm playing against are smart. So if I was in his position, I totally would have attacked with dual hand, because judging by all the cards that I do have, none of them have high defense points. Except for my attack Kalantoso. Did I know that wasn't? No. So not, I don't think any of my cards add cards to my hand. Come on, obedience gold. Can't use this card, and I can't leave my field open. So I have to set. Come on, do something dumb like overlay or something so I can activate my card. Come on, stop making good plays, stop it! I think I lost. No, I live for another turn. I still have one more chance to get obedience school. And no, they can't make cowboy. They can't cowboy me to death. Yep, I live with 115 life points. Oh my god. alright. So, in my defense, why did we get this card? I was gonna say maybe if I save that card, then I can also get out Kalantoso, but that's not possible. Nope. So I lost. I should surrender and be generous to time, but. So, that's pretty much all for this, I want to say episode, but it's this battle, because we still have two more battles. Maybe those will be in different episodes, I don't know, because this one is 20 minutes long, because this one was really a battle. Mainly, these battles go pretty quick because raccoons are just too good, man, too good. But we lost our first battle. Hopefully, we can pick up the second two. But this one was really close in my defense. So I'm going to type in GG. Also, a lot of people don't do it on YuGiOh Pro, I've noticed. Alright, so. That's the end for this one. Final thoughts is, my final thoughts would just be also just coming back to this. I might want to revise the deck. Also, if you guys have any revisions that you would make to my deck, please put in the comments below. But with that, we'll see you in the next episode. Final thoughts from me would be, I wish I looked at the guy's name so I could make a pun on that, but respect your local raccoons. You know what, if a raccoon comes up to your front door and he looks hungry, feed it. With that, we'll see you in the next episode. I said that like 3 times. What am I doing now?